on rusty razors, broken bottles if I please. I wanna wake up in the grips of a thunderstorm. Let me bleed, let me bleed, I wanna bleed. Upon the sea, I want to sail into a turning cyclone. Let me bleed, let me bleed, I want to bleed.
Thank you. saw Bob Marley just before he died. He was mostly a machine. A crankshaft and flywheel pumped his lungs, but at the front of his face were still all of his ancestors, right down to that tree. A television screen separated the two of us. I touched its electric hairs, and I thought of the quotation marks driven through Christ's wrists, and that a lightning bolt starts from the ground up, like a skeleton, thrusting a bright hand up through the earth. Anyone. And there's a bright, beautiful, waiting at the top. No te quiero, no te quiero, no te quiero ver. No te quiero, no te quiero, no te quiero ver. No, I don't want to see you. No, I don't want to see you. The Trinity, the treason, the trident, the event horizon drawing. Closer to the single point where the pages are rustling. They are my skin, my hide, my scales, my leaves, tearing for you. Take. Do this in remembrance of me. That would be the perfect murder.
Well, I don't care.
There was an old boarding house in the corner, in an old town a long time ago, where the dead crows went to roost. You were that house, and the dead crows were a physical manifestation of your demons in the past that haunted you. Living crows represented spiritual health and youth, with tranquility being the final roost in the sky. And life for you was a series of distortions in time, leading to salvation in the tranquil gardens. Young children fell in love with themselves, life, each other, and the universe. The crows lived on in peaceful, sedated harmony. The children ran headfirst into their uncertain futures. The adults applauded and cheered. It was wonderful. Life changed and turned its back at them at some unknown point in time. Minutes, seconds, bits of computer memory, dust and red tape. The crows inside the house grew bitter and cold. Kids needed to go home and crows needed to roost because everyone was telling lies. So they continued to lie, and they got stuck with a whole lot of dead crows roosting in their attics. A million crows sang the dead song and whistled a dead tune. A million dead crows crowed in the mist. A million dead crows came to roost in the vacant home. The young woman saw her grandmother lying sickly on the floor, an old antique rug covered in vomit. Such a pretty death. The young woman threw her grandmother into the trunk of the car, and she headed for the hills, headed for the heavens, the house where the crows went to roost. She hated those damn birds, and they hated her too. It showed in the way they squinted and held out their claws. The summer cabin, refuge, home sweet home. But you can never go home, all the way home, just like it used to be. She dug an early shallow grave. The crows intensified. They grew black from all the negative sanctions, the guilty conscience, the eyes of the world, personal politics. The crows were like cops. They didn't stand for murder. It just wasn't in the cards. So those crows did what they do best, and it was the cops who found her in the house on the hill where the dead crows went to roost. And now you are that house where the dead crows roost. Dead crows are all the people and places you've left behind. So don't look back, because you can never go there.